Hello everyone. Yeah, just testing the voice first. Good afternoon, and really thank you for being here. I'm hoping for the panel, but now it's like presented by myself. But hopefully I can give you like a brief overview of freeware channel in Indonesia and how the market's growing and also the situation at the moment. Yeah, my name is Abi. You can call me Abi. It's Agustinus Abimanyu, and I'm now it's like more into the content side for the program acquisitions, and also several of the animation from Malaysian and international also broadcast in freeware channel in Indonesia. Okay, when we discuss about talk about the Indonesia, it's kind of like really like now it's kind of more than 250 million people in Indonesia. So it's kind of number 4, if I'm not mistaken, number 5, you know, the people itself. And also he has 16 million islands now in Indonesia, and I don't know where is it inhabited and where is it non-inhabited, and but it's scattered around the equator. It has a lot of diverse culture in Indonesia. So why I have to present this one first to get like some idea how the free-to-air is quite important at the moment in Indonesia and still important. We have a 3 segment of time belts as well. And more when I found Indonesia is now becoming more and more proud nation, because there's a lot of development in our government and everything else. That's why it's also impact to the content as well. And the one thing that, because before this is like a free-to-air, it's like a traditional media, they always already do already like the free content. So I have to enhance this one also, because what we did is like we schedule a lot of contents with the free for the advertisement. From the internet. And in free-to-air channels itself, now we have like 11 channels for the free-to-air in Indonesia. So I think the battle for us in terms of the battle and everything is like every day. So after we got like in the 10 a.m. we got a performance from the Nielsen, and we always like discuss about how we can growing our channel, like how we can develop, how we can increase the performance. It's all about every day, like weekdays and also in a Saturday as well. That's why for the 11 channels and the free-to-air basis is kind of really harsh together, like a battle and competition is really harsh. And now, not only the free-to-air nationwide that we had, we also have like a network TV in our side. So why is network? Because they gather like a local TV to be branding as a one TV channel. For instance, is like iNews TV is actually is more than 30 local cities of local TV in the 30 cities, and now we can also get them if the performance is more likely can be upgrade into like a free-to-air nationwide, because now the Nielsen calculating 12 cities. If they already qualified the 12 cities, they can describe them as a free-to-air nationwide as well. There's a Net TV as well with the big budget programs that we have. They have in local programs. What is habit in a free-to-air in Indonesia, especially the competition between the free-to-air, is more into the streaming programs. One program is come from Monday until Sunday every day with the development of like a series drama and everything else. And regarding the production value, probably because of its like probably shooting this this day, and then next week they being put it on air, is kind of enhancing itself in terms of before is the quality is quite low. Now because of the system is already growing there, they can increase the quality of the program itself. And the habit of the that we make for the audience also, every day is a fresh program. So the rerun programs sometimes is not as catchy as the fresh program, definitely yes. But it depends on the program itself, whether is it the program is a series drama series, or the program is a animation series. For animation, they can okay, because like children tend to like one episode to be rerun so many times. It's okay if the schedule is good as well. We analyze that, and not every animation can be like that. And one thing for sure, the habit is like all for free, even for like a big show, even for a small show. So they already have the habit of watching there in their TV for free. Audience, because they have it now, and also because of the diverse and the amount of people that we have, 250 million, and by the time now, I think the scheduled audience still in there, and now still growing. I will show you later on the capture from the newspaper as well, how it still can grow. Why I put like Gen X and also versus Gen Y? Sometimes now the Gen X like us is more into like a schedule person. They already get used to the habit that we go time by time. But now the Gen Y is also parallel with the internet. They can watch the one that they want and not waiting for the schedule, but they want to be there when they need it. And what I find in the analyze and also the performance every day, day by day, is now it's not the branding itself. The branding is important. The TV channels A, B, or C is important, but the content now is becoming more into the king. Before, it's just like probably the performance of the television is just in the probably number 7, but when the content is really catchy, it can come up into the number 3 at that time slot. Like football matches, the big football matches, the local football matches. Before they had the football matches, it's just only they turn to be like rank number 7 or 6. But when there's like a local football matches, they can go up into the number 3. It's so in some case it can be like they more loyal to the content, and it happens to a lot of genres as well. So now, why I also share Indonesia before as a proud nation or as a more local, because now the local content is one of the biggest share performance of biggest get a performance from the audience is from the local drama. One of the local drama itself in the prime time is kind of like hit more than 30% share for all the audience. And there's also local entertainment. Like I say, what local entertainment is this one? It's Dahsyat. It's every morning. And also there's like inbox. This one is kind of like a music show in the morning, but not only the music show, it's more cute to comedy as well. So it can drive all the for the all the audience. And Anak Jalanan over there is we call it Sinetron, because Sinetron is drama series about young guys and there's a gang versus gang, but it's not really in a violent way, because in the regulation we cannot broadcast any really violence kind of a drama series, but it can reach more than 30% every day, and it runs for every day more than 2 hours. So you can describe how 30% more than 30% share more than 2 hours kind of show every day is the production schedule and everything, it has to be really tight. And also the local features, we have a local feature like adventure and everything. It is sweeping every day. The one that I want to address here, stressing here as well, is the one that can broadcast now for the streaming kind of a way. So like every day or weekdays. And one thing, because the audience like the free content, and also the advertising still love us, hopefully until in the future, we can also bring the big budget contents like The Voice, X Factor, and big sport programs, Premier League. Like back then, in 3 years ago, we can broadcast every match games in the Premier League for free for two channels in MNC TV and also in Global TV for that at the time, and it's all for free, and Champions League as well in RCTI. We also broadcast blockbuster movie. Just sharing that because I'm come from Global TV, our prime time more into the movie slot. We have 3 movies back to back every day. We incorporated with 4 major studios at the moment, and also we buy from other studios to fulfill the needs of the audience. So every day is kind of like HBO kind of way or not, but we want to have a more variant into the action, because we have a Chinese movies as well, instead of just only Hollywood titles. There's a big hit with the Indian and Turkey dramas now. ANTV, one of our competitors, let's say, is really have a lot of happiness with the Indian and Turkey drama. You can have a back-to-back probably 4 Turkish or Indian dramas in the prime time slot. And now I have to describe that the dynamic kind of like variant of programs in Indonesia is really dynamic. Probably today, if I talking to the distributor or something like a genre of like animation or a big budget programs, probably it can be not suitable for this time, but it can be suitable for just only three months later, because the demand is there. It's really what we call it, because the audience really like the content, and the content is the king. So sometimes it can be changed really sudden. For it's not as sudden as like next week, but it really can be okay, there's like opportunity from the profiling that we can fit with the programs that probably we don't need like for 6 months before. Local news is doing great, because we have a lot of local kind of a lot of things happen. Like every day is like probably there's something, some corruption that that caught by the our commissioner of corruption, and afterwards there is like, and always there is a news in Indonesia, and hopefully when we see it, it go to the something that we hope that Indonesia will be better and better, because our government I think now is kind of a really serious about the how to improving this country. Animation in here is really one thing that we maintain for Global TV is we maintain from 2006 or 2005, from the beginning of we are incorporated together with Nickelodeon, and also now we are incorporated with the Marvel, and for MNC TV as well have Upin Ipin, and for also Adit and Sopo Jaryo in MNC TV. In our case, other than Nickelodeon and Marvel, we also have Super Wing. So something that we need, but it's not a prime time, but it's really important for us. But the one thing for sure why we are cherry pick the animation title, because in the industry is really I think every year is really huge, a big catalog for the animation programs, and for us one thing for sure, the slot time is really limited, because none of us for the free to air is a kids channel. We are more into general channel. Two stations in free to air is a news channel, but none of us is a really kids channel. And the one that play animation titles is just only I think four channels. Yeah. For us, it's probably the limitation of time slot, we have to really careful to pick the animation title to put on air. Whereas we already have a lot of inventory in our lineup, and most of probably 50% of the or 30% of our inventories haven't show in the or haven't broadcast. So that's the one that probably later on in here have to understand that why we are really cherry pick the animation titles. And also I have to stress out the regulation from the government, whereas the international local versus international program has to be 60% versus 40%, which is makes sense. Now local programs also have the highest rank in our platform, so it's not a problem. But for Global TV is kind of problem, because in the prime time we on air movies, and also there's an animation in the morning. So, but we have to catch up to be 60% and 40%. Now it's analog versus digital. It haven't been like a really strict regulation, or really before the plan is having a digital Indonesia last year, I guess, or the last 2 years. But it's still being discussed by the community of free to air and also the government, because to change analog to digital is not really simple for us. First, from the audience side, probably 70% is still doing with this one, with analog TV, not the digital TV. So who provide the setup box? Who provide the decoder? And how it can be impact to the performance later on? And before there's a discussion that probably the FTA and also the government will share the setup box to be distributed to the audience. How they distribute? We have more than 13,000 islands or 60,000 islands, and it's scattered around. It's not as simple as well. And to be like they have to pay to be from the TV, like analog TV, to go to be the digital TV, they have to spend. And in a lot of areas, I think to spending to something like this is not their priorities now. And but for digital, if digital grow to be like from the FTA digital, like I think for the next future have to be a digital. There's also like a challenge. Now it's just only fixed for the 11 channels. Now can later can be more than like, because the canal is more is can be one canal to be probably 5 or 6 digital or more. I don't know if high definition is just only four channels, but if non high definition could be more than like more than that. So the one thing that for sure that really need to be rigid is regulation. If the regulation is not there, I don't know what happened, because like all of a sudden a lot of television is showing up, probably from 11 to 50, and they just want to broadcast 24 hours a day, and the content itself is not like a big budget content again, because they have to just only to show. And I think later on it can be like survivor of the fittest, who's gonna live and who's gonna die as well. And for the industry itself, the advertisement will be, I don't know, they probably the red card is for the television is the same as the radio or even the print. I don't know, it can be like that for later on. So the regulation is really important, that probably being discussed with all the free-to-air and also the government. And how I can see the growth of the free-to-air industry now? I think the free-to-air, I captured 2 slides from the Nielsen presentation, Boulder Consumer. But to show how it's still maintainable to have a free-to-air and still grow. In here, in consumer media view in 2015, the TV still grow 2%. When we say traditional media, has been no traditional, has become, can reduce now the number of consumer, but it's grow 2% now. So in terms of that, still growing is okay, because like 2015 is not a good time for Indonesia at the moment. The economy growth is not really pleasant, but still it grow, the customers still grow 2%. And there's like several generation X, millennials, and Generation Z. When they watch the television, is still in the number top 1 or 2. Watching TV is still 34%, still 36%, and still 36%. And I think the audience consume television free to air, especially in Indonesia, is more than 3 hours, yeah, from the last time that national show. And this one, I get it from the 18th of this May. In regard to advertisement, so the quarter one of Indonesian free to air still growing quite significant, and still cigarettes in the off prime time, in the prime time actually. So the regulation for the cigarettes advertisement have to be after 10 p.m. in Indonesia, 10 p.m. in the East time. So we have a three time belt. Is it the east west time belt? Sorry, west time belt. So 10 p.m. And the other one, the second one, is the government advertisement spending. Before there's like a huge advertisement spending in terms of polio vaccine, and later on they will also spending for other kind for the for other kind of a reason for healthy or traffic or whatever. But the interesting thing is in here there's also the online shopping who spend quite a lot in free to air. So the online shopping there's also the OTT basis also spend in free to air, and other e-commerce also spend in free to air. So still, I think the favorite one to put an advertisement in the media basis. Why is FTS still promising? The audience still grow from the last slide that I show you, and also the advertisement still grow. More than 60% of advertisement sales budget is go into the free-to-air basis, and it's still growing until now. And the number of the advertisement still growing. The products, I mean, like before it's only 1,000, probably later on could be 1,200. And example of the OTT base, Hook is spending quite a lot last month, if I'm not mistaken, Hook as the OTT basis. Why? Because it's the FTV can the coverage, also the awareness, and also the reach for the FTA itself is one time and it's nationwide, and it's on your face. We don't. It's kind of like that. Probably, if you can, I can describe. It's like that. It's on your face. It's for free, for the all the audience, and it's nationwide for the all the islands, and they need also to be exposed in the free-to-air basis, even though the media basis is different. It's internet basis. They can spend in the Twitter, in the Facebook. Yeah, they spend Twitter, Facebook, and everything. But probably the impact is not as big as spending in the free-to-air. That's why I'm still believe that the free-to-air basis is still really promising. And because I'm come from the MNC, from the Global TV in MNC, I have to also put it like describe something about MNC, which I think in Q1 2016, our MNC as free-to-air basis is RCTI, MNC TV, Global TV, and iNews TVs. The total average share still in 36%. And total prime time average share is almost 50%. It's 46.7%. And the last presentation that sales present for the Q1, we are still best in West in sales revenue. Means that best in the total sales revenue, best in numbers of advertisement who go to the our group, and there's a several kind of a best of the best as well. So hopefully this is this presentation can also give you like some information about overview the free to air basis in Indonesia now, because before really I'm hoping to get like a panel discussion rather like this one, and but hopefully like this kind of a small presentation can give you some kind of information. Thank you. Thank you.